Is this one of the most versatile speakers on the market? Let's check it out. Dave Taylor here, and I'm looking at more audio gear. This time we're looking at this. This is the Riva Arena. It's part of their WAN series, and Riva is probably a brand you haven't heard of, but you should have, because they make really nice audio gear. And this is their first of the WAN series. And what they've done here is they've said, how can people connect? Let's make sure we support all of it. So you can use this as a Chromecast device, as Bluetooth. It can create its own Wi-Fi network. There's a ton of ways you can use this. And most importantly, it sounds awesome. Let's give it a listen. Now, of course, what you hear is not exactly the same because you're using my little mic here. But I can tell you, this is pretty darn impressive. Volume control on the top. And you can hear, there's a lot going on with this music, and there's a really nice sound stage. I feel like we should have a techno party. Let's pause though. So, the way they do this is they have this magic, this technology called Trillium. And what it does is from a single speaker, it gives you a spatial sense to the music. It's pretty slick. Now, they have three different active drivers and three passive drivers, a total of 6 ADX drivers, and this thing delivers 50 watts. It gets crazy loud, for sure. Now, the three active drivers are 60 millimeter, and then the three passive radiators are 66 millimeters, and they have a 3-channel amp, which is how that whole Trillium system's working. You can use it with Chromecast via Google Home, super easy. It is not actually a voice-activated speaker, so make sure you understand this is just a information going into it, and it plays. It also supports Spotify in a way that you can start Spotify on this device and then it will stay playing. Even if the device you started from, even if the device you started from, you then power off, which is really cool. So it is part of the Spotify ecosystem. It also supports Wi-Fi, DLNA, AirPlay, if you have something like an iPhone or an iPad and you want to just push it out that way, Bluetooth, supports high-res audio. There's really pretty much nothing it doesn't seem to work with, as far as I can tell. And they have their own app. And in their own app called the WAND app, which makes sense, in their own app you can fine-tune things like the bass and treble and such. I have not needed to adjust it, but you can. Now, let's also look at the controls. On the top is a set of controls. You can see in the close-up that you have pause, play in the middle, volume up, volume down, previous and next track, and there's some overload of functions depending on what you're doing. And then that ring, I have it, it's blue. Turns out that it has a whole ton of different colors. In the manual, it explains it can be green, red, orange, dark blue, light blue, purple, or gray. There's a lot of different choices. There's a lot this can do. And then on the back, here's something I really like, is there's actually a mounting screw. If you want to mount this on the wall or otherwise make sure it's not going to rumble its way off your table, it's not going to do that. You have that option. And it has AUX in, and it has a USB plug that you can use either to feed music into it, or you can charge something off of it. If you want to just plug in your phone or something, you can charge it. I'm not sure when I'd do that, but it's another option. And then there's this little switch on the side, and the switch is interesting. This is the HomeAway switch, and you can buy an additional battery that you would then plug in at the bottom, and the battery will give you 20 hours of play time. And you can switch this either with the battery or if you were to take this to a hotel room or something. It's kind of big to be traveling, but give you great sound. But you can switch it into away mode and then it becomes a Wi-Fi hotspot. And then you can connect your devices to this and play music through it. Super smart. So that's what that little switch does. Most likely, if you're like me, you'll have it in home mode all the time. Let's see. So the optional battery, I should say, costs $99. And this is 5x5x7. You see it's kind of a square on the top. And it's pretty heavy. It's 3 pounds. So there's a lot going on inside this device. And I will also say the finish quality is excellent. It's a really nice device with the metal screen and a plastic. It's very, it all looks really good which is good because it comes with a fairly premium price tag. But before we get to the price tag, do me a favor, click on that subscribe link, and if this is useful, thumbs up, never hurt anybody here on YouTube. Awesome. Now, the Riva Arena, part of their Wand series, this is $249. You can learn a lot more about it and pick up one or two for yourself. If you get two, that boom, it gives you more stereophonic. Pretty sweet. You can pick that up at rivaaudio.com. The optional batteries there for $99 if you want to make this a little bit more portable. I'm not going to do that myself, but I am going to go back to my music. So I will catch you in my next video. Thank you.